In a chamber deep within the heart of Tanlagal dwell the devourer. The walls of the large rounded caravan were polished clean and smooth. It was as if the very mold and slime that invested the rest of the sore walls had been consumed. The stone walls glowed with an eerie blue light, filling the otherwise empty chamber. The air was stale and lifeless, and the smell of something rotten clung to everything. The devourer itself was nowhere to be seen. The empty lair seemed almost to be daring me to enter. A cold sweat coated my skin underneath my black leather armor, and I could feel my heart pound in my chest. As quietly as I could, I drew the sword from its sheath at my side. The long sword blade was slimmer than most crafted by hunter skilled hands, resulting in a blade with perfect balance. The demon carved hilt of the sword enfolded my hand like a glove. Hunter had told me it was forged using skill long forgotten to this world. As I held it before me, I began to understand what he meant. The blade lightly vibrated almost in anticipation of the battle to come. I summoned a barrier of protection around me and gradually stepped further into the chamber. The smell of rot became overwhelming as I reached the room's center. I felt the bile creeping up the back of my throat and swallowed hard. It was then I heard the sound of what seemed like the sap leaping from a tree. I looked up at the ceiling, just in time to see the huge black mass fall from above. I dove to the left, rolling upon landing, and reached the floor frame just as a rubbery liquid landed, covering the floor of the room. I recovered and stood, only to be yanked from my feet just as suddenly. The black ooze had swallowed my feet and legs up to my knees. It quickly covered the rest of my body as I hit the ground.